Hey everybody. Wanted to reach out to you today and see how you're doing. How are you holding up? What is your emotional state? And what's going on in your world today? What are your thoughts? What are your feelings? What is your mental state and also your physical state? I actually had three people reach out to me this morning about their anxiety and that they couldn't sleep at night and they woke up very anxious and worried and fear, it has set in. So for a lot of people, let me just shut this off. Let's see if I can silence my phone. Here we go. For a lot of people, obviously, we're faced with so much uncertainty. We are faced again for so many people with fear. A lot of people shared with me last week how they suddenly have so much fear about getting sick, or fear of death is very common right now. Worried about the future, what's gonna happen, and really what we can do is just go day by day and face the day head on. And hey, Deirdre, thanks for watching. And most importantly, what we can do right now is focus on what we can control. Focus on what do we have, and stay in a place of gratitude and grace and empathy for ourselves and kindness. Because here's the other piece. Number one, the news, right? Right now, as much as I'm not a big fan of watching news, and I never was, in a sense, it's important to stay aware and awake to realize what's really going on, what are the changes of the day. So you want to really become get real and figure out what's the message of the day, right? But you don't want to spend hours and hours in front of the TV. Just get the data and not the drama, like we like to call it in coaching, and see what you need to do with that information. The one of the things that you absolutely don't want to do is stay in anxiety, stay in worry, stay in fear. Allow that to swallow you. Why is that not good? It's because it hurts your immune system. It depletes your energy stores, and it actually inhibits you to make good decisions, to make powerful decisions, which is something we all need to do right now. Day by day, we don't know what's going to happen. So much is out of our control. I'm not going to argue with that. But what is in our control? What can we focus on? What can we do? There is still so much that we can do. And as I've worked with so many people these last couple of years, helping them completely overcome anxiety, I'm going to tell you honestly, I'm not a big fan of band-aids. I'm not a big fan of, oh, do the tapping and do this to help. But now I will share so many of these band-aids with you, because the most important thing right now is for that anxiety to not allow for you to not allow it to escalate. Okay, because especially as we're faced with this challenge, which can compromise our health, especially now, it's important to not let the anxiety consume you. Okay, now, number one, actually, and I want you to appreciate and adore this about yourself, anxiety is healthy, normal, and good. Okay, so just know that you're not broken. There's nothing wrong with you. It's a good, healthy response. Having human emotions is wonderful, and that just means you're healthy and you're feeling things. And anxiety, really, all it is, not all, but thanks, Dennis. Thanks, Suzanne. Hi, Savelle. The good news is you don't. And when I say you, if you're somebody who tends to become anxious easily, right? You don't have anxiety. You do anxiety. And there are many, many, many ways to undo anxiety, okay? So that's the first thing I want to share with you. Appreciate that your body is responding in a way that it should, which at the root of it's fear. Anxiety is fear, okay? Fear about the future, to be specific. And get that this is normal and this is a good thing. But once you become aware that this fear is showing up, become even more curious about it and ask yourself, what am I afraid about right now? Wait a minute, is there a tiger chasing me? Is the world coming to, you know, what specifically are you fearful or anxious about? And once you become aware of, okay, these are the current circumstances, the tiger is not chasing me, there is no need to fight, flight, or freeze, which is generally the response that people go to when they experience chronic anxiety. So fight shows up in anger, in rage. You know, there's nothing we can fight. Freeze, yeah, anxiety will keep you paralyzed. It will keep you like in this, now what? Oh my God, right? And that's not useful. We cannot afford to be that right now. Fight, flight, or freeze. And flight, we're all in the same boat. We're all in the same, on the same planet, so there's no way to escape. So the most important thing is to recognize, okay, I'm feeling anxious right now. I'm worried. I might be scared. Okay, I'm human. This is good. This is normal. I got it. And just appreciate that your body has an amazing response. Because on the flip side, there are people that are completely dissociated from their emotions, from their, and again, that's from years. And either those people are trained, which you can train yourself to become dissociated, like military, police, you know, there's a right time and a place to be dissociated when you have to act and you have to just get out of your feelings and take action. You know, doctors possibly right now, and nurses, this is probably really useful to them because they must take action. They have to do it anyway, even if they feel the fear. So you can train yourself to do that, but generally speaking, it's not healthy to be completely dissociated from your feelings. So the anxiety is a good thing. It's healthy, it's normal. So just know that, you know what, this is a good thing. But as a human with a conscious mind, you can now make a decision for yourself to be like, I am not gonna sit in this anxiety and let it consume me and let it swallow me, because that is not good for me. It's not good for anybody to experience chronic anxiety. And so as we're going through these days and weeks and who knows how long, this is a wonderful opportunity for us to teach ourselves how to navigate our emotional responses, our mental responses to the things that we're experiencing inside of ourselves. As you know, again, we're surrounded by people, by our families. One of you might have a freak out moment, another one might feel sad, and another one, you know, we're all gonna have go on this roller coaster together. And so this is such a great opportunity for us to learn how to not stay in anxiety. Again, why is anxiety not good chronically? Okay, chronically meaning acknowledge it, understand it, and then be like, okay, now what? Now what do I do? There are three things that you want to sort of redirect as soon as you experience anxiety rising up. Three things, super simple. Your breath. Once you take hold and control of your breath, you can change the anxiety. Once you change your body posture, that's another way to immediately redirect the anxiety to something that is more useful. And your thoughts. What are you thinking? If you are continuously thinking, oh my God, what's going to happen? I'm going to lose the house financially. I'm going to get sick. Those are just thoughts. And the truth is, these are thoughts that you don't know whether it's going to become true or not. And if this is something you don't want to happen, then immediately change your thoughts to what do you want? And the easiest way to redirect your thoughts is to go into gratitude. Okay, what do I have? What can I be grateful for? What resources do I have? What is at my fingertips that I can use right now? For example, the big things that I keep going back to is, oh my God, our food supply is untainted. We have fresh air to breathe. We have running water. You know, we have internet. I don't call this social isolation. I call it social connection. We can connect with anybody in the world if we really want to and feel closer to each other, right? So there are things. Sorry, my phone keeps. Yeah, I know. I'm gonna get back to everybody. And so these three things, breathing, when you breathe, generally speaking, anxiety is shallow breathing, quick breathing, and you're feeling like your heart is coming out of your chest, so you want to do your best to redirect your breathing to deep, long breaths. Inhale for four counts through your nose, exhale through your mouth for six counts if you possibly can. This takes a little bit of training, and the more you do it, the better you become, and the more you're now helping your immune system, you're helping your energy reserves, you're helping making decisions that are useful. And I'm happy to share a lot more with you on that. And one quick tip that I want to give you, talk about band-aids. And again, what you want to do is interrupt this anxiety in your body. Anxiety is mental, emotional, and physical. Your thoughts, your feelings, and your body part, because your body constricts in anxiety. So if you interrupt any of these three, you can change how you feel. So one of the ways you can do that is simply by taking a water bottle or a phone. I don't know if you can see me here, but you want to just pass this water bottle side to side, allow your arms to come out. And what this does is it stimulates the right and the left hemisphere. And this in itself interrupts the pattern of anxiety. Just this simple exercise. Do it for about a minute. And now notice. So I also invite you to, before you do any of these things that I'm sharing with you, check in with the number of, on a scale of 0 to 10, where is the anxiety for you? What is the number? Where 10 is a panic attack, 10 is like freak out mode, and 0 is calm, peaceful, feeling good, feeling confident, feeling clear, clarity. And 5 obviously is when you're starting to notice that the anxiety is getting worse, your thoughts are getting out of control. If you catch it as soon as possible, this becomes extremely effective. And actually, it's no surprise that this is a water bottle. Stay hydrated. Stay hydrated. This sounds so simple. It sounds primitive. It sounds like, what difference does it make? It makes all the difference. Staying hydrated makes all the difference right now. As soon as you hydrate yourself, that fresh oxygen goes into your brain. And once again, your brain feels more resourceful, more calm, more collected, and you want to keep pumping fresh oxygen into your system as much as you can. So the bilateral stimulation is something you can do anytime, any place, even walking down the street. You can pass your phone back and forth, and it might appear to some that all you're doing is exercising, but this is very effective in helping you get back into what is called the parasympathetic nervous system. You don't want to be staying in sympathetic nervous system, which is anxiety, which is the fight, flight, or freeze. You want to bring yourself down as often as you can. So as we're looking at this, who knows how long ahead, this is the time to train. Okay, this is a time to practice gaining control over our mental, emotional, and physical well-being. And if you want to take this to a much, much higher level, I can absolutely help you with that. Really get into the programming that has been running this anxiety for so long that you basically do subconsciously. You don't even realize that it's happening. So I can certainly help you with that. But for these Facebook Lives, my goal is to give you tools that you can immediately apply and immediately get results and feel better. And please hear me. The more you do this, the more effective it's going to be. So you might do this for one time, be like, oh, it didn't work. Yeah, no kidding. One push-up is not going to get you the toned physique, the strong muscles that you want. The more you do it, the more effective this becomes. So with practice and with integration and with action, you will have amazing results and you will feel better, which ultimately will give you the health that you need right now, will give you the energy that you need right now, and the focus to stay, committed to, okay, we're gonna get through this. And we're gonna be strong for it, and we're not gonna let this defeat us. So if you have any questions about this, please feel free to share. And I'm also offering right now anxiety relief workshops, specific anxiety relief workshops. If you're interested, they're free. I've put together an amazing, really an amazing presentation that gives you the most important things you need to know about anxiety in a nutshell and tools that you can implement immediately. Hi, Eve. Thanks for watching. Hi, Roberta. So if you have a group of people together and you wanna be part of this presentation, you want me to share with you, I would be happy to, because this is really, really important information right now that all of us can use, and you know, also to be able to have people lean on you to show up, you know, because we don't know how a threshold is like. Some people feel stronger certain days, some people feel weaker certain days, and we all need to stand together right now and show up for each other and be there and be empathetic and be generous and be grateful and really, really do what we can. So let me know if you want any specific information about anxiety, worry, panic attacks, or anything like that. I'm here for you. All right? Take care and please be safe.